warmed welcome along here to McDonough Park in Enna for the Dr. Harty Cup hurling final between St. Flannan's of Ennis and St. Michael's CBS of Limerick. It's a game that's certainly got all the ingredients of being a great one. So let's hope that you at home and us here in Enna should be in for a cracking encounter. So let's now have a look at the players on the field prior to the start of the game. If hunger is the required ingredient for victory, then St. Michael's CBS of Limerick will not be found wanting in today's Dr. Harty Cup final. One has to go back to 1967 when the famed Sexton Street last won the title. Victory over North Mon and Middleton gave them a semi-final clash with last year's winners St. Coleman's of Fermoy. There were underdogs going into that contest, but all the stops were pulled out on February the 21st and Sextons were back in the Munster College's final after a lapse of 9 years. Young Albert Shanahan, there you see him in your camera, number 15 there, has been very much on target this season for Sextons, to date scoring 112. The South Liberties man could well have a vital role to play in the outcome of today's game. St. Flannan's, on the other hand, well, they have been the kingpins of hurling, colleges hurling, for many years, and today they contest their fifth successive final, having played in 29 Harty Cups all told. The Innes nursery will not lack an incentive to win today, having lost to St. Coleman's in last year's decider. En route to the final, they have accounted for Temple Moor, Patrician Academy of Mallow, and in the semi-final outshined De La Salle of Waterford. Certainly a very big crowd, really looking forward to the encounter of these two great hurling nurseries, St. Flannan's of Ennis and St. Michael's CBS of Limerick. John Kelly, the referee there, with his back to you from Tallow in Waterford, the man in charge in the middle of the field for today's eagerly awaited Dr. Harty Cup final. He's been there with him and a man with much experience when it comes to colleges hurling. There you have both teams making their way behind the Enna brass band, and as they do that, the jitters there, young Brian Tobin jumping and leaping, and Albert Shanahan the last man. It gives us a chance to go through both teams. Limerick CBS will line out as follows: Natello O'Grady in goal, David Butler corner back, Anthony Teefy full back, and Pat Hurls in the other corner. Barry Foley is half back, David Holmes the captain of the team at centre back, and Mark Moynihan is the other half back. Clement Smith and Dave Hennessy will hold up centre field, while Alan Purcell, Tony Houlihan and Keith Cregan will be the half forward line. The full forward line will be Paul Neenan, Tom Fitzgerald and Albert Shannon. A lovely shot there of Neenan in the background as the team's making their way. St. Flannan's have Padraig O'Leary in goal, Pat Connellan is cornerback, Paddy Guilfoyle, the Aero Oldman, is fullback, and David Hoey is the other corner. Terence Fahey is halfback, centre-back James Healy, the captain of the team, and the other halfback Gordon Blem. Rory Burke and Richard Woods are centre-field, while Martin Conlon, Fergal Hegarty and Dermot O'Riordan are the half-forward line. Brian Tobin, the Limerick man from Mungret, is in one corner. Barry Quinn is at full forward, and Niall Toohey is the other corner on the St. Flannan's machine. The final huddle together with David Holmes, the captain, in there in the centre. The familiar shot of so many teams now as they get together for one final pep talk before the game. I wonder what Holmes is saying to them at this stage. It's a case of bottoms up.
Thank you. down.
Sit down!
John Kelly, the match official in the center of the field. The action coming together here at McDonough Park and Nina in County Tipperary for the start of this, the Dr. Harty Cup hurling final. John having a final look at the watch because it was delayed somewhat of the large crowd making their way into Nina. We may have a final figure on the crowd a little bit later on. John Kelly in the center looking number 8 there. David Hennessy in front along with number 9, Richard Bland. Clem Smith anxious to get things underway. John Kelly painted out the Dr. Harty Cup hurling final is underway. Here come Albert Shanahan whipping of the ball quickly and CBS trying to get him there some way, somehow. Pulling it in along at the half forward, Keith Seagham. They're on the attack straight away. James Healy's in there trying to get it up and they're all trying to incite the Shanahan on the ball. Shanahan inside along with the cornerback, Pat Connellan. They're there again pulling. Somebody has it. It's on the ground. Number the corner forward is in there. This game is really for it. Oh, really getting off to a thundering start outside to the center field man now. Here they come, Pat Connellan with a shot and making no mistake about it. Well, the goalkeeper inside, let's go back in because it's a goal. It's a goal inside. The ball went into the net, the umpires called in the referee, and it's a goal. A dramatic start to this game, and CBS get what must be the greatest start they've ever got in the competition with 56 seconds gone of the game. Padraig O'Leary, 17 years of age from Newmarket, getting ready to puck out the ball. The might of St. Flannan's and Limerick CBS, and the ball being pucked out here. Clem Smith on the ham and underneath it. Smith has the ball in his hand. Powerful hurling from Smith up the field as they go on attack once again. Whipping it is the halfback, Turban Spahi, driving it onto the centre where Richard Woods adds for it further down the field. They're all there trying to make something of it, but breaking out to the half forward Martin Conlon foul on the first free of the game to St. Flannan, and it'll be taken by their corner forward. Corner forward Brian Tobin standing over the ball from Mungret. That's the angle, hitting it high, and it's gone to the left and wide. On to the left and wide. Well, of CBS, they couldn't have asked for a better start than that one. The goal came after a barrage of hurling went in and eventually going into the back of the net. Long puck out from the goalkeeper. Natello Grady pucking the ball long to the centre of the field. In the hurling panel last year, Clem Smith, this man sees no danger today. Bustling right through, Rory Burke is in there whipping of the ball. A little bit vicious is the referee, John Kelly. And it's going to be a free in for Sexton Street, and David Holmes looks like he's going to hit this one himself. There goes David. Here he comes. Dropping it in, but gone to the left and wide. The left and wide, so that makes them equal on something at least at this stage. Both sides have had an opportunity of scoring points, but both of them have put them to the left and wide. Limerick CBS, a goal. Innes, St. Flannan's, no score. The goalkeeper, Padraig O'Leary, getting ready to puck this ball out again. Plays in goal sometimes from Newmarket and Fergus. Whipping on the ball now, driving it in, it's Fergal Hegarty. Has scored 4 points in the competition already. The full forward, Barry Quinn, whipping it in. But the goalkeeper, Natello Grady, will be happy to leave that one out over the line and wide. Natello Grady comes from a great hurling family in Patrick's Well in County Limerick. His father, Jim, chairman of the local club out there. Here he comes. Look at the boss of that hurley. Well, the old scheme had him big, so why not Natel? Driving the ball long, right close to us here. Caught and trying to drive it down the field at the half-forward for Limerick. Keith Cregan, nephew of Eamon Grimes, a man well known at college's hurling as well, and indeed captain of the last Limerick team to win an All-Ireland back in 1973. Nine ball, chipped well by the halfback Barry Foley again from Partick's Well. On the pole again,
breaking out, hurling it well down the field out of the half-back, Terden Spahi. Being collected inside, the centre forward still motoring through is Fergal Hegarty, has got the ball in his stick, trying to size up, flaking it across, and that's a beautiful point. An absolutely beautiful point, and Natel O'Grady, he's in there in the goal, telling his backs to mark up a little bit more tightly, but making no mistake about it, a beautiful point from Fergal Hegarty. That gives Hegarty his fifth point of this Munster College's campaign to date, just 18 years of age. That's from Kilnamona. Natel O'Grady's long puck out to the far side of the field. CBS moving the ball well. James Healy on the ball, comes from a great hurling family. Driving the ball downfield, and again, they're inside in the danger zone, but Natel O'Grady controlling it well and blocked down. It's dangerous. It's dangerous to the corner forward. A shot. It's tripped it over the bar. No mistake about it. Night to you, the Clare Castleman, making no mistake, but it could have been a lot more because Natel O'Grady had come out of the ball and possibly waited a little bit too much and was hooked as he tried to clear it out the field. 2 points for St. Flannan's, a goal for CBS Sexton Street, and that early goal that they got almost cancelled out now with just over 5 minutes of play gone on the game. Clem Smith going up for the ball, breaking down out of the half forward. Fergal Hegarty still trying to motor through with it. Hegarty manages to do so inside to Brian Tobin. Tobin 45 yards out, a shot down, put it up and put it over, making no mistake about it. Putting it straight over the bar. That gives the Mungret man his 15th point of the championship. O'Grady, well, he's pucked the ball out more times in this first few minutes of this game than he has been possibly in the whole competition. Smith whipping on the ball again along with Rory Burke, trying to get it. This man could play havoc because he's motoring well on the ball, but CBS starting to tighten up a little bit, and Keith Cregan coming more into the game. Old style hurling, whipping the ball overhead here today. The fullback going for it now is Paddy Guilfoyle. Paddy trying to bring it out to his left hand side, managing to do so, but very close to the line. Rory Burke going for it, but the ball had gone out over the line anyway. Line ball for CBS Sexton Street. And the man getting ready to take it, Keith Cregan, just 17 years of age, from Croom, wearing that new style hurling helmet, chipping it, a beautiful chip in right into the 21-yard line, and CBS hurling the ball well in the air, inside to the corner forward, hitting it right across, but it's only as far as the fullback, Paddy Guilfoyle, driving it out towards the centre of the field again. Batted down by Barry Foley, that small man as far as Clem Smith, the powerful Smith coming through with the ball, fouled on his way through, and that'll be a free in for CBS. John Kelly, the referee, making no mistake about his decision there, very much upper to play, and a free in, and Albert Shanahan is coming out to take this one. Albert has scored one goal and 12 points in this game, in this championship already, and that's the distance. He has a shot, and he puts it over. A lovely score from Albert Shanahan, very, very accurate from Freeze, and he's starting this game well. Little over 8 minutes of play gone, and CBS Limerick still applying the pressure. A goal and a point for them, just 3 points for St. Flannan's. Mighty puck out, wind-assisted puck out there from Padraig O'Leary to the far side of the field. They're trying to scoop it forward again inside to the corner forward. They're still turning him in there inside, but gone to the left of the post and gone wide. The corner forward, Niall Toohey there, driving it in with his left hand, but a little bit too far to the left and wide. Hello, Grady, opting to drive it to this side of the field, getting a good distance into it despite the wind against them. Fergal Hegarty going for the ball, but it's going to be a line ball for St. Flannan's. Be taken right in front of us here, the centre fieldman Rory Burke. Yard Drahan man, that's the distance he has. Opting to drive it in sort of low, batted in by the half-forward Martin Conlon, going for inside to Brian Tobin. Onto his left hand, but blocked down by David Holmes. Outside to Clem Smith. This man plays a direct type of hurley, but was fouled there. David Holmes again fouled on his way out. Clem Smith rather blocked down on that occasion, but it's going to be a free out now. The captain of the CBS team, David Holmes, will take this one himself, playing at centre-back. Both captains, incidentally, holding down the number six shirt in this game. On to this side of the field. The cornerback bringing it out is David Hoey, but got out over the line and out for a line ball. And Keith Cregan again will take this one. Cregan getting under the ball, chipping it inside. Not going all that far though, going far enough is Moynihan. Driving it way across towards Albert Shanahan. He's still coming through. The hand pass didn't work out for him, but cleared out by the halfback, Thurden Spahey, way down the field. There's a very, very strong wind blowing here. Now it's Brian Tobin, the Mungret man, on the ball. A lovely crisp strike across to this side of the field. Still going for it. They're all fumbling and bumbling around the ball, very close to the ground, but the referee, a judge there, that the half-forward Martin Conlon was fouled as he went for the ball, and it'll be a free in. Brian Tobin, the man that swung that ball across to this side of the field, he'll be the man to take it himself. He has had one opportunity already. It didn't work out for him then. Will this one? Make no mistake about it. Brian Tobin puts that one over the bar and gives him his 15th point of this campaign. Sides are now level. St. Flannan's 4 points. Limerick CBS 1-1. Ball breaking down the centre of the field again. Burke hurling the ball well up to the full forward, but cleared out by the fullback Anthony Teefee. The Ballybricker man to the hand man, and it's Clem Smith scooping along the centre to Keith Cregan on the ground, but being bought up by the halfback Gordon Glenn. Glenn to the Dermot O'Riordan with a long ball in, but that one has gone to the right of the post and wide. Little run of Natel O'Grady. He drives the ball to the far side of the field. Brian Tobin trying to pull on the ball along with the halfback Barry Foley. Ball being now breaking away to the centre, being pulled by James Healy, the captain of the team, but from one captain down to the other, and Holmes doubles on it up the field again. Can Tom Fitzgerald make something of it? Very close to the ground. Tom with the helmet half off, being brought down there, but the referee give him a go ahead, and the man coming out with the ball is Richard Woods. Doubling on it first time. This is very good hurling from two teams. Adamant to hurl well today. Now it's St. Flannan's on the ball once again. Beaten in last year's decider by St. Coleman's. Not anxious to lose on this occasion. Now they come with Hegarty. Fergal Hegarty on the ball. Doubling it in inside. Think to bring it out. Being flicked away from him. The corner forward Niall Toohey has it. But not for long. Here comes Smith. Clem Smith on the ball. But he's not getting the assistance because Martin Conlon brings it out to his left hand. Swinging it right across, but gone to the right and wide. The CBS defence under immense pressure on that occasion. And Natel O'Grady getting ready to puck out that ball once again. Well, contemplating as to which side of the field he'll drive it to. Here he comes. Managing to get a good past the second 65 metre line. Rory Burke doubling on the ball. Trying to go back and tidy the ball up. There is Mark Moynihan. Fergal Hegarty again on the ball. Doing an awful lot of hurling in the early stages of this game. With less than 15 minutes of play gone in this first quarter now. Here they come again. Trying to bring it out is Teefee. Hurling along the ground. The halfback running down for his Thurden Spahey. Doubled on it and awarded a free in there. Free end, and James Healy, the centre back, has come upfield to take this one himself. About 50 metres out, a strong wind at his back now as he strikes it. Long distance out, not giving it too much height, and making no mistake about it, and St. Flannan's go into the lead for the first time in this game with just 15 minutes of play gone on the watch. 5 points for Flannan's, a goal and one for Sexton Street. Nattel getting a drink of water there from one of the team mentors, Joe McGrath from Burrisalee. Well, Nattel having a look at things and surveying as to what's happening. Referee John Kelly giving the go-ahead. Pucking the ball out. Going in under it again. David Hennessy. Taken away from him though by Richard Woods. Collecting his hurley a little bit shorter and driving it into the corner forward line. Toohey with a shot and putting it over the bar. Niall Toohey making no mistake about it. It came in from a bit to control it while in the hand. And flake it over the bar for a good strike with his left hand side. Attilo Grady again with the puck out to the centre of the field. Hurley gone from the centre fieldman there, Dave Hennessy. He'll get a replacement in a few moments, no doubt. Scrappy over there now as they're trying to collect it, and St. Flannan's are stamping their authority a little bit more on this game. Rory Burke, versatile and hitting with both hands, flaking the ball down the corner forward, but only as far as the corner back. David Butler, he's whipping a little bit, but manages to bring that ball up and is fouled. Well, yes, he's fouled. He didn't think he had actually got that free for a moment, but he did, and the captain of his team, David Holmes, will get ready to take the free. Hurler with great potential, and no doubt will be wearing the Limerick senior hurling shirt in the not-too-distant future. Long ball down towards Albert, down his wing, but turns Fahey, clears it down the field for St. Flannan's, but gone out over the line on the far side of the field, just there in front of the Sexton's dugout. And here comes that line ball in again. Flaking it in towards Tom Fitzgerald on the full forward line. The full back trying to bring it out is Paddy Guilfoyle. And fouled on his way out there. And it's going to be a free downfield. A substitute coming in. And that just will tell you how seriously that St. Flannan's are treating this game. They're bringing in a substitute. And it looks to me, I think that's Tighe Tobin. And that's the Black Rock Band, originally from Kilfenham in County Limerick, Vince South Limerick. That's Tighe Tobin, a hurler of great ability, a little bit of injury on this time. We'll have a look in a moment and see who's coming off. He's coming in at half forward, and the free is taken and driven infield. Driven infield. On the ball and trying to attack it once again. Niall Toohey whipping it across the square. They're all in there to go pull back. Toohey trying to bring it out some way, somehow, only as far as Fergal Hegarty, and he makes no mistake in tapping that one over the bar. Tapping that one over the bar, Fergal Hegarty. As I said in the earlier stage of this commentary, he's been very, very industrious around the centre forward line, and he's marking David Holmes, the captain of the St. Flannan's, or the CBS team. Clem Smith on the ball, gathers it well under pressure, doubling it inside now to the full forward line. They get inside, can they make use of this one? Tony Houlihan, the Adair man, trying to go for it, but gone off and out over the line for a line ball. Kermit O'Riordan, I'm told, is the man that has left the action. We'll just check that in a couple of moments. No difference, but the ball has gone out over the line. Line ball for CBS Sexton Street. Clem Smith, the man that'll take it himself. A very, very big occasion. Almost 20 minutes of play gone. Can they make use of this one, as Alan Purcell has it? Trying to drive the ball in, that's going In okay, but to the left and wide. Wide. The goalkeeper, Padraig O'Leary, throwing out the replacement hurley. You mightn't have seen it on there, but the striking. Here he comes with the puck out. Just look at the distance he's getting into that puck. It had gone way over on the far side of the field there. Brian Tobin. Very number 13 wins himself. A very big crowd you can see there in the back. A very, very big crowd here at McDonough Park for this game. Fine ball in. Look at that dangerous ball. Natello Grady just managing to control it. The flick didn't come out that well from inside to the full forward. Barry Quinn, they're in there, but here they come, and CBS Sexton Street saved on that occasion by Foley, bringing the ball out and hurled well up the field by Clem Smith, and the action coming a little bit livelier. Tom Fitzgerald on the ball, racing towards the 14, across to Shanahan. It's a shot, a goal! It's a goal! The ball has got to the back of the net for a goal. Well, now we'll have to wait and see what happens, because there is one of the players down injured. One, it's Tom Fitzgerald who's down injured, but what a goal! It came right in, and Shanahan made no mistake about it. A blistering goal, and Tom Fitzgerald, the captain of the full forward on the CBS team, from a hard, just 16 years of age, in fifth year, is down injured. They're all making their way in there. In there with the bottle, Willie Moore, and Ted Hurley is in there as well, the doctor of the team. Willie Moore, corner back on the 73 team that won the All-Ireland. And of course, the man that has worked so hard for the promotion of hurling and giving off of you. There's Moore in again, pointing the finger and telling them to get into this game. Well, let's hope that everything will be okay, but a lapse in defense there. Joe McGrath in the background talking to the umpire. But he's asking him, did he see exactly what happened? But CBS won't mind. They're back really very much in the game now. The sides on level terms again. 2 goals and a point. Shannon, 7 points. Pat Lurie having a word with John Kelly there. And now let's see exactly what happens here. Well, is the goal going to stand? It's not. Well, one would have thought on this occasion that he may well have given the advantage, but it's not going to stand. Well, Albert Shanahan, he got the original one that hasn't stood. What will he do with this one? Here he comes with the run. A shot, a goal! It's got in, and makes no mistake about it this time. If you didn't record it the first time, says Alan, well, Albert Rother, you can record it now. The number 2 goes back up on the board. 2 goals and a point for CBS Limerick, 7 points for Ennis, and Padraig O'Leary getting ready to puck out the ball again. This game has certainly come alive now in the last couple of minutes. 23 minutes almost gone of the game. And Clint Smith has cleared it down the field with Tyke Tobin, the man that came in. Whipping on the ball, the cornerback David Butler got out off of him and out for a line ball for St. Flannan. Well, one of the players is down injured. That line ball just won't be taken for a moment. We'll just have to see amongst the mirage of people who are in there as to who exactly is down injured. Pat Fleury in there having a word as well. And there goes Joe McGrath. The referee has given the go-ahead meanwhile to continue with the play, and let's go back to it as they come onto it. And the halfback racing up for the ball now is Gordon Glenn, throwing the ball very high up into the air. It's a dangerous one, hanging in around there, and just barely gone to the right of the post and wide. Well, a little bit of dissatisfaction here at this side of the field. The man that's down injured, Pat Lurie, he is not having any of it. Natello Grady, meanwhile, pucking the ball out to the far side of the field. Pat Fleury not too happy, no doubt, with that decision. But the game goes on, and Sexton's really on the attack once again, gathered by the fullback, Paddy Guilfoyle, the era Oakman, driving the ball far down the far side of the field over, and it'll be a line ball. behind Paul, over on the far side of the field. The half forward, Alan Purcell, another Patrick Swell man, just 15 years of age, trusted with this one. But the man who was down injured is back on his feet again. The half back, in fact, it was Mark Moynihan that was down injured, and he's up and he's okay. As Alan Purcell getting ready to take this line ball against the back shot of the goalkeeper, Padraig O'Leary, who seems to have fumbled it a little bit. They're turning on it, but nicely hooked by Keith Cregan. Cregan on the ball, turning it right in across James Healy, controlling it well, blocked out by Tom Fitzgerald. Dribbled it out the field now by David Toey, outside to the half forward, going for his Keith Cregan again. And here comes Tyke Tobin, the substitute again, with a big long relieving clearance down to the full forward line. They're trying to make something of it as the corner forward. Niall Toohey driving it in across, but collected by Travels the ball out of the air. Tim Smith goes up in the centre, but again, here comes the towering James Healy upfield with the ball. Blocked down. This is tremendous, Hurley. Putting it straight over the bar. A lovely score from James Healy. Natello O'Grady again getting ready to puck out that ball. Flannans go back in the lead again. 8 points for Flannans, 2 goals and a point for Limerick CBS. Puck out from O'Grady, breaking around the centre. Rory Burke going for it. Pete Cregan whipping it not all that far, only as far as Houlihan. Tony Houlihan driving it inside to the full forward line. Tom Fitzgerald and the full back, Paddy Guilfoyle, go for it together. Breaking outside now, they're on the ground, very close to it. It's Paul Neenan, but taken away from him and driven upfield by Paddy Conlon. They're all going for it, but it's gone out over the line, and that will be a line ball for CBS Limerick. Clem Smith will take this. Here comes Clem. Taking a quick one inside. Didn't work out all that well, though. CBS trying to make something of it as we come approach halftime very shortly now. And the numerical advantage shown by St. Flannan's around the centre of the field is starting to work for them, but can CBS level it up before they go in at halftime with a nice ball in from Dave Hennessy? The fullback beaten again inside. They're trying to collect it. Will it go towards Shanahan? Flicked away from him and cleared downfield by Terence Fahey. Blocked down again, and they come forward with the halfback. The halfback with a shot that high and putting it over the bar. A lovely score from Barry Foley. Putting it straight over the bar. A lovely inspiring point, and that will keep CBS on target. 2 goals and 2 points for them. 8 points for St. Flannan, and the game is nick and nick here at McDonough Park. Very, very entertaining as the goalkeeper, Padraig O'Leary, again getting ready to puck out the ball, drives it down the field. Holmes tried to gather, but it's Fergal Hegarty who has beat him and has gone inside him. Has got Tyke Tobin. Tyke Tobin flicks it with the corner back. David Butler just managing to get a stick. Out comes Slim Smith and Rory Burke going for it as well for Flannan. Now here comes Holmes, doubling it on the left hand, but not going that far, only as far as Brian Tobin. Throws it well up in the air, put it up and put it over. No mistake about it from Tobin. A craftsman with that hurley puts it straight over the bar. St. Flannan's holding that little bit of edge all the time, now leading by another point. 9 points for St. Flannan's, 2-2 for CBS Limerick. Natello O'Grady, there will be a little bit of time maybe to be added on for this first half, but can Dave Hennessy put it on the level terms going and approaching the break? Hennessy with plenty of room, about 55 metres out from the goal, had a little bit of time but has gone to the right, and the umpire emphatic there that it's gone to the right and wide. O'Leary not giving it as much height as Clem Smith wins the ball again towards his half forward Alan Purcell of the halfback Turban Fahey. Foul there, and this is an opportunity for CBS to put it on level terms again, but the referee having a word with Richard Wood, and in fact taking his name, the first to be recorded in the little black book of John Kelly. at this Dr. Harty Cup hurling final. CBS last won it in 1967. 26 years of waiting is a long time, and David Holmes put it on level terms again to the left and wide. Have had plenty scoreable opportunities, but they'd want to be taking them. The goalkeeper having to run out to the 21 to collect the ball. Rick O'Leary. And that will be that. It's half time here at McDonough Park and Nina in this Dr. Harty Cup hurling final. St. Flannan's go in at half time with a slender 1 point lead. St. Flannan's 9 points. Sexton Street CBS of Limerick, 2 goals and 2. Join us in a few moments after the break. Welcome back here to Nina for the second half of this, the Dr. Harty Cup hurling final. And it's almost ready to start the second half now with St. Flannan's of Innes holding, as I said at the outset, that slender margin of just 1 point. 9 points for St. Flannan's. CBS Limerick, 2 goals and 2 points. And they're the centre field pairings. They'll be joined now by John Kelly, their match referee in the centre. No changes that we're aware of so far in the game. We can tell you one that though that Brian Tobin has switched from the half-forward line to back into the corner. John Kelly is almost ready to start the second half, and they're away. Can CBS get the start in the second half that they got in the first? They're on the attack already now with Tom Fitzgerald blocked down, thundering, trying to come through a little bit. Industrious, okay, but didn't work out. Can Keith Cregan do something with it? Here comes Cregan on the ball. He's gone to three players, managing to kick it a little bit forward, but took a little bit too much out of the ball, and it's now going to be a free upfield for St. Flannan, and James Healy will be the taker of this one. James Healy, his brother, already holds 2 Harty Cup hurling medals. So too does James. Will he make it his number 3 today for him? And just have to wait and see as Healy drives that ball way up into the sky, dropping on the 21. They all go up, but the number 11, Fergal Hegarty there, was the man who pulled a little bit wild, and it's going to be a free upfield. Well, James Healy, the centre back and captain, took a free at his side of the field. David Holmes can do likewise. He drives his ball downfield again. Healy going for it. Being helped out by his half-back, booting the ball upfield, not too far though by Terence Fahey. In there trying to help him along the way is Alan Purcell, but Purcell is fouled, and it's going to be a free end for St. Flannan, for CBS rather. Albert Shanahan making his way out. Here comes Albert Shanahan on the 65-meter line. The angle is quite acute. About 15 metres in from this side of the field. Here he comes. Not getting under it all that well, though, in as far as Tom Fitzgerald. They're all in there trying to do something with it. Rory Burke turns the ball well with the left hand to the far side of the field towards Tyke Tobin. Tyke Tobin on the halfback, Mark Minahan. It's Tobin from Kilfinan at County Limerick at school in St. Flannan's. Drives the ball into the full forward end, but TD's having a great game at full back for the CBS of Limerick. Outside to his centre back by David Holmes of the Hurley, starting to speed up as the ball goes down the field again. Trying to bring it out as the corner back, David Hoey. Outside his centre forward, Tony Houlihan. Houlihan getting away from him and gone down as far as Tobin, and just flicking away off of his Hurley out over the line for a line ball for Limerick CBS. Clem Smith will be the taker. Willie Moore in the background there, and along with the subs bench, they would so eagerly love to win this Harty Cup that hasn't rested by Shannon side since 1967 at the CBS in Limerick, and that line ball will have to be taken again. And now the half-back is going to have a go at it. Mark Minahan. Here comes Mark. Not going all that far though. Trying to bring it down the field is Tobin along with Fergal Hegarty. Both players wearing blue helmets. Goes back to the halfback. Moynihan down the field. Doubling on it well.
and gone to the right of the post and wide. Little over 3 minutes of play gone in this second half, and still just 1 point separating the sides. Long puck out from the goalkeeper O'Leary, falling kindly for Richard Woods as he races upfield with the ball, but Richard took a little bit too much out of it, disgusted with himself there, took a little bit too much out of it. It'll be a free for Limerick. Now David Holmes, he's got the wind at his back. It seems to have died a little bit, but it's strong down there on the pitch. If he could meet this one correctly, it could go over the bar. He's taking great detail and great attention at it, the stance of the captain. Here he comes. Just look at it go. It's got the distance, okay. It's got the distance by a mile, but it's gone to the right of the post and wide. Then Flannan's came into this game very much the favourite, but CBS Sexton Street seem now to have risen to the occasion, but there's a long time left in a jet as it's hurled down the field now by Keith Cregan. Nice ball, but James Healy covering an awful lot of ground, flaking the ball well up the field. They're all going for it, but it falls inside to Brian Tobin, but no, Hurley had passing the ball inside. He's still going through now inside. He's in the forward man. They're trying to do something with it. Half blocked out again by the CBS man. Keefe is in there, the full forward. Barry Quinn has got the ball on his stick, but not for long. Keefe is playing very well. Outside to Martin Conlon. Conlon going for the ball. Inside now, it could be dangerous for St. Flannan as they try to come forward, but Holmes has picked up a facial injury, but still going on as Keefe going for the ball. The corner forward now, still trying to gather this ball up and make something out of it, but it's going to be a free end. A free in, Brian Tobin, the corner forward, working very hard to try and make something of it. He lost his earlier in an early one. Attack David Holmes, picked up a little bit of an injury there, but he seems to be okay. There is no way he's going to be leaving the action. Here comes Brian Tobin. Will it put a 2-point deficit between the sides? And he does. His second point of this game and his 16-0 in this current Munster Colleges campaign. 2 points between the sides now. 10 points for St. Flannan's. 2 goals and 2 for Limerick CBS as Natel O'Grady with a long ball down the field. Still going for it now. They're trying to break the ball down the field. That's a half forward turning it in. It's Tony Holan. Inside, can Limerick make use of it? Inside the top Fitzgerald, the corner forward racing for it. He's trying to get in there some way. The corner forward, Paul Needed. Take it out over the line. And the opportunity that went to begging. He rushed through. He had 2 more of his colleagues with him there. And it just didn't seem to work out. An opportunity that could have seen them take the lead if they had got that goal. And they need a goal now to fire them up, because they'll find that hard to come back against this St. Flannan's team. And if they can get their nose in front, they won't be too anxious to leave it slip. Corrig O'Leary again getting ready with this puck out. Here he comes, driving it to this side of the field. Dave Hennessy going up for a long with Richard Woods, trying to scoop it in there some way. Now is the halfback, Gordon Glenn. Terence Fahy is there as well. Terence Fahy going on for it. Grabbing his hurley a little bit shorter as he breaks it down the field towards the half forward Martin Conlon and the corner back David Butler. Collected now by Tyke Tobin. Tobin riding the tattle and breaking this ball well across, and it's gone out over the line over there. Hard. A line ball. For Limerick CBS, and the cornerback David Butler will be the man to take it. David Butler chipping this ball well down towards Keith Cregan on the halfback Gordon Glenn, but again gone out over the line there, just in front of the
Sexton Street dugout. Almost another team in the background. Lovely ball in. They go up, but collected by Terden Fahey, driving it long and hard down the field. David Holmes managing to get his stick to it and turn it on, but only as far as the half forward Martin Conlon on the Flannan's team, but he took it a little bit too far and out over the line. Mark Moynihan getting ready to take this line ball on the far side of the field. The Drummond Flackerman, just 17 years of age, getting under the ball well. Down towards Fahey again, being turned away now towards Keith Krieg, and this is a lovely shot in, a dangerous ball. It's a shot in, a goal! It's a goal! Albert Shanahan has put it in the back of the net for a goal! His second of the game, and what a goal from him! Albert Shanahan, he had 1-12 coming into the game. He has 2-1 scored now so far, so that would give him a tally of 3 goals and 13 points in this contest already, in this total Munster Championship Colleges campaign already. 3 goals and 2 points, the 10 points. I said they needed a goal, and Albert was there to do the business. Goalkeeper Porrick O'Leary, having his name, going into the little black book now, the second of the St. Flannan's men to have it recorded. And Sexton's hold a 1 point advantage again. 3-2 for Sexton Street CBS, 10 points for St. Flannan's, and all is a fight for now, with almost 11 minutes of play gone of the game, and the crowd really starting to get excited at the outcome of the contest now. What way will it go? Now with a long puck out of the goalkeeper, Porrick O'Leary again, breaking in the centre. The hearts of many are thundering now as to the outcome of the game. The halfback collected it is Barry Foley. Now David Holmes, breaking away from him though, it collected by Richard Woods. Nice ball inside, he was fouled. Jersey pull there, the referee says, as he went through. And again, James Healy will be the taker, has the chance now of levelling the contest again. The stance of Healy, a vital free. 1 point separating the sides. CBS to the good. Well, then, and it's over. The sides are back on level terms again. What a game. They've been to-ing and fro-ing all afternoon. This is their fourth occasion to be level. 11 points for St. Flannan's, 3 goals and 2 for CBS Sexton Street. Don't rule out the possibility of a draw. Here they come again, trying to make something of it now, bringing it out the field. Richard Woods doubling it along the ground. He collected, nicely controlled by Barry Foley, whipping it, a nice ball for a half forward. There to collect it is the halfback Jordan Glenn, flicked away from him by Keith Cregan. Cregan now only as far as James Healy, controlling the ball well, deciding to come forward. He likes to come forward with the ball. Onto the stick without catching it, Sean Foley of Limerick, and Patrick Well used to do that so well. Now they're on the attack with the half forward Martin Conlon, going right, hurls it left across it towards the corner forward line. Toohey now all alone going for the ball. Heading towards him is Pat Earl. Toohey is blocked out again. Lovely bit of marksmanship. This is Hart at his very best. This is Hurley at his very best. As Pat Earl tried to come out field with the ball. Barry Foley back there to help him. And this is Hurley at his very best in this college's hurling final. Barry Foley, I think that's the man on the ground. John Kelly having a word there, but Pat Earl, Pat Cleary, a captain, former captain of the Offaly team that won in All-Ireland. A corner back himself, David Holmes, captain, the leader, in there, and he'll take this free. Well, that ball, when it came in, it could have posed much danger for Sextons, but they have managed to bring it out, and great defensive work from the cornerback Pat Earls, and Barry Foley in there to assist him. Did the business. Meanwhile, while David Holmes is ready to take the free, it looks like Richard Woods is receiving attention. Well, it's not Richard Woods, actually. That's the corner forward. Very much like the physique of Richard Woods. That's Niall Toohey, the corner forward. Scored 2-7 in his tally already coming into this game. David Holmes getting ready to take this free. Gets under it well. Little over 14 minutes of play gone in this game now. Fumbling a little bit with the ball as Terence Fahey coming out for it. Can Houlihan make something of it? Flicked away from him and driven down the field by Martin Conlon, the half forward who's above played in the half back line. It's Holmes, the timber, the action is coming alive. David Holmes and the Fergal Hegarty go for it together. Being flicked out again by Tiffy as he races for the ball, but it's Hegarty who's got the ball. David Holmes not leaving him in. Inside to the half forward, a full forward, a shot, a goal! It's a goal! Barry Quinn, the 6 mile bridge man, raced through the defence and banged it to the back of the net, and that is that. Raced it right through. Slipped inside the defence, just watch him coming in again. He got it and turned it out to his left-hand side and banged it to the back of the net. And that's the tonic that Flannan's really needed. A goal and 11 points to 3-2. Can Sexton's fight back from this one? Conlon was the man that started the action from the half-back line. And remember, he's a half-forward. It's Tyke Tobin on the ball now. Tyke Tobin still coming through, throwing the ball up, but took it a little bit too far, and it'll be a free downfield for Sexton. St. Sexton to Michael CBS and St. Flannan's providing the action here in this Dr. Harty Cup hurling final. David Holmes again will be the taker of this free, about 90 yards out from the goal. Here he comes with it. That's a mighty long delivery. Drop it inside around the 14. Shanahan was running in, but Patrick O'Leary, the goalkeeper, gauging it well. And it looks like he's gone out over the line. And the umpire has called in the referee, John Kelly, to have a word with him. And we'll see now. The goalkeeper, Patrick O'Leary, already has his name in the book. And what is he saying to him now? Already has his name in the book, remember. Getting ready now to puck out the ball. Meanwhile, off your screen, Pat Fleury has switched Albert Shanahan into full forward, and Tom Fitzgerald has come to the corner forward for Sexton Street. As O'Leary pucking the ball out to the centre again. Dave Hennessy on the ball, driving it in as fast as it came out towards Albert Shanahan on the fullback, Paddy Guilfoyle. And there again, trying to bring it out, whipping of the ball, not all that far though, as Pat Conlon breaking it, just gone out over the line, trying in vain to keep it in with Terence Fahey, but it'll be a line ball for Sexton Street now. Tony Houlihan. This is third year playing Harty Cup hurling with a beautiful line ball inside there. It's dangerous, but it's Rory Buck who gathers it from the breakout from the forwards down towards Martin Conlon with the new style hurling helmet, flaking it down now. Can they make something as Earls just manages to get a hurley to it? David Holmes trying to bring it out there along with the centre forward Fergal Hegarty, but not going all that far. Whipped out by David Butler, driven further down the field by Smith, but it's going very close to the line. Can they keep it in? Paul Neenan there. But it's gone out and wide. And one of the St. Flannan's men is down injured. It's the man who has received attention already. That's Niall Toohey, the Clare Castle man. still receiving attention. Conwoods is in there with him, but everything, he's not going to lead the action too easily. Pat Custy, the round man, was warming up in the line meanwhile, but he'll have to revert back to the bench, no doubt, in just a couple of moments. Padraig O'Leary again getting ready with this puck out. Pucks it way out. But the referee has asked now that the ball possibly be pucked out again. Well, what has actually happened, I think, is that he passed the 14-meter line when pucking out the ball, and the referee is now giving us to CBS Sexton Street. That's exactly what happened, I would imagine. You're not allowed past the 14-meter line, and for doing that, you broke the rules, to the referee, John Kelly, and it'll be a 65 in for Sexton Street. Shanahan with the shot that is clean of the whistle. A beautiful score by Shanahan, just lofting it over, and the run of him back into the full forward position again. 3-3 to 1-11. Two points separating them now again. Long puck out from O'Leary. Brian Tobin going for it. Decide to leave it a go on the carpet. Pat Harrells has it. This man is playing well in this second half. Coming into his own. Ball breaking down. CBS not watching the break possibly as closely as they should do. Back to the centre back all alone. Guarding that position well all day is James Healy. From one centre back to another, just barely slips inside, but Earls is there again, playing very well at cornerback. They go down for it again. Can they do something? Paul Neenan going for it, the cornerback. David Hoey turning it to this side of the field. Barry Foley didn't really have time to pick it, left it go on the ground. Here they come with Dave Hennessy with a long, dangerous ball inside again. Shanahan is there trying to turn it out, but look at Healy back there again. He's playing tremendous early and really playing a captain's part. Look at that delivery with his left hand down to the far side of the field, but gone out over the line, a line ball for Sexton Street. It'll be taken by their halfback, Mark Moynihan. Sub coming in now for... Just gonna pass your screen there. Pat Custy, the Ruan man, 18 years of age, making his way in. And Niall Toohey, who was down injured twice in the game, making his way off. Meanwhile, Barry Foley is receiving attention just to the right there. Looks like a cramp. And Pat Lurie is in there with him. That's a cramp, okay. This game really very tense. And anything can possibly happen. The St. John's Ambulance men in there trying to ease the muscles and get rid of the pain. Dr. Ted Hurley is there as well, just opening his bag, bringing out the magical spray. Great goalkeeper in his own right, in his own day. Associated now, of course, with the Patrick Wild Club. Line ball goes ahead on the far side of the field. Barry Foley will be up, I'd imagine, in just a couple of moments. But Rory Burke gathers that ball and drives it out over the line again in the far side of the field. But it took a deflection on the way out off of a Sexton Street hurley. And it's going to be a St. Flannan's line ball. Sexton's having just 14 men on the field at the moment. Barry Foley still down injured. Not for long. He's back up and running as this line ball is taken by Rory Burke over there. Collected by Mark Moynihan, now blocked down as Martin Conlon still trying to come through. He's hurling very well in this second half inside towards the full forward, Barry Quinn. They're all pulling. Teefee is trying to bring the ball out. Here comes Pat Earls. Played a real blinder at cornerback. Foul at the 21-meter line. It'll be a free out for Sexton Street. The watch is reading 23 and a half minutes of play gone on this first second half. But Healy grabs the ball out of the air again. Look at the shot of him coming up the field, the ball. Total control by this man as he zooms up along the field. Releases it inside to Brian Tobin, the Mungret man. Still coming with the ball. About 45 metres out at a cute angle. It's over. A lovely point. A smashing point by Brian Tobin. It all started from Healy gathering the ball at his own 45 metre line and with a dashing run upfield. Natello Grady now knows that there's no time for to be wasted in this game. Willie Moore and Pat Lurie on the far side of the field wondering what can they do at this stage. And Willie Moore is having his name actually taken in the far side of the field by the referee, John Kelly. There goes John Kelly, just taking his name. And Willie won't mind having his name in the book if the result is the way that he would like to have it at the end of the game. 3 goals and 3 points for Sexton Street, 1 goal and 12 for St. Flannan. It's tight and it's tense. 24 minutes gone of the game now. Inside is Keith Cregan with a shot, leaving it off quickly off his hurley. It's over. That's a very good point. Came out of nothing, really. Gathered it at centre forward and just flicked it off at his left hand over the bar. There's nothing in this game. And certainly it's there for the winning now for Sexton Street if they have the power to come back. But Flannan, their never-say-die attitude, and especially the hurling of Healy at centre-back, could be what they're looking for in the last few minutes of the game. They go up again and bring in the ball now to the centre. Rory Burke flicked away from him by Hennessy. Downfield now, trying to gather the ball. Clem Smith is in there. Give me the ball to Smith. And he gets it and not getting it all that far. Only as far as Turns Fahey, the halfback, driving it up towards Pat Earls again. And Pat Custy, the man that came in. Look at this man coming out and out. Teefee, the fullback, playing a great game. Flicking away from him now, Pat Hegarty. Inside to the full forward, Barry Quinn. Quinn, cute, calm, gives it inside to Rory Burke with a shot. Rory got to the left and wide. The left and wide, Natello Grady searching, looking for a ball. Where is it gone, he's saying at this stage, and having a word with Joe McGrath, who has just passed around the back of the goal. Well, if Willie Moore can have his name taken, so too can Con Wood, because it goes into the little book. Good for the goose is good for the gander, as Natello Grady again getting ready to puck out this ball. The watch is reading 26 plus seconds, got 26 minutes and a good few seconds gone in the second half of this game, and there will be, I would imagine, a couple of minutes of extra time as well added on for injury time as Sexton tried to come forward again. Gathered by the corner back, driving it upfield is David Hoey. Hoey driving it up from one corner position to the other. Earls going for it, but falls to Brian Tobin. Slipping his marker, Barry Foley, off of the left-hand inside towards Natello Grady, who controls it all alone and gives it a long delivery down the far side of the field again. They go up and try to bring it down, but the full forward who has come all the way up to the half-back trying to defend is Barry Quinn at this stage. They realise the pressure. It's attacking again. Going for the ball, Natello Grady sells a little dummy. Got a slight heart attack, I'd say, on the way out there as well. But has come 15 metres with the ball and delivers it long down the field again. Now, here comes Slim Smith with the ball. Slim Smith about 40 metres out. Half hooked and half blocked down the hand, man. The Spuds will be boiling if they win this game. But they try to come forward again. Now, they're all in there. A lot of hard pulling. Rory Burke is the man with the ball. Drives it into the crowd over on the far side of the field. And a line ball in for CBS Sexton Street. The watch officially reading about 2.5 minutes of play left in this game at McDonough Park here in Nina. A line ball over on the far side of the field. A goal and 12 for St. Flannan. 3 goals and 4 for Sexton Street. Well, it was a line ball, but it's now going to be a throw-in. It's put in, and there Houlihan trying to collect it and bring it out along with the cornerback, turning it up the field is Pat Connellan. Flaking away from him and driven up the field by Martin Conlon. Conlon drives it up again now, and it's Brian Tobin going for the ball along with Barry Foley. David Holmes is in there along with the cornerback David Butler. And Holmes trying to bring it out is blocked down, got out over the line. That will be a line ball for Sexton Street. 28 minutes and 33 seconds gone in this second half of this game. A line ball to be taken by the halfback Mark Moynihan. Moynihan chipping the ball, gives it low along the ground to the centre where it's collected by Hennessy, turning back to make room for himself, gives a long ball inside to the full forward line again, breaking out now towards the half forward Alan Purcell. Alan Purcell and the halfback Gordon Glenn on the ground trying to bring it in now the corner forward. In a cross inside towards Houlihan, Tony Houlihan, and it's going to be a free M. A free M for Sexton Street, but it's a little bit acute and a little bit far out. One wonders what they'll do with this one. They need a goal desperately to come back into the game. 13 points to 15 or 3-4 to 1-12. Chad Howard has shot, he plays it. It's a goal! It's a goal! The ball has got to the back of the net for a goal! It's a goal! And Sexton have come alive! What a goal! They couldn't see really what happened. And the hearts of people around the ground at Magdalena Park have gone absolutely wild. 4-4 to 1-12 is O'Leary. Pucks the ball out the field again and the place has gone absolutely wild now. Will it be back to Sexton Street for the first time since 1967? Brian Tobin picks the ball up in the ground and Sexton Street couldn't get a better start than that one. David Holmes, composure and coolness is required at this stage, and my watch is reading 30 minutes and 10 seconds of play gone in the second half of this game. I said maybe a minute and a half of extra time. Here comes David Holmes with this free, 90 metres out, a shot that's going high, put it up and put it over. I think at this stage predictions that CBS of Limerick will have ended the 26 years of deadlock, and the cup may well be going back to sit at St. Michael's CBS in Limerick. My watch is reading 30 minutes and 40 seconds of play. 4-5 to 1-12. Wonder what John Kelly is doing with the whistle at this stage. Comes on again of the halfback. Moynihan is going for the ball. The far side of the field and pulling it down. The game has come very much alive. The cornerback doubling up the field is David Hoey. Is there life left in Flannan yet? Don't write him out. They've great tradition. They've got four in a row of a pass, of course, in between 44. Between 44 and up along to 47. They had four in a row. CBS also had four in a row in 64, 65, 66. And again, the last time they won it in 67. Moynihan with the ball, drives it down the field. The hearts are ticking away. The hearts of excitement are really blazing. And CBS Sexton Street go for the ball over the far side of the field and out over the line. And now the shoe is on the other foot. Flannan definitely know that they've got to get a goal, have got to get a point to come back into the game. 4-5 to 1-12. They come forward once again with Brian Tobin. Tobin racing forward. The Mungret man coming through with a shot that's high, gone to the left and wide. It's wide. Tobin, that lovely craftsman with a hurley in his hand, puts it to the left and wide. Sextons are gone absolutely wild in the far side of the field. 1-12 to 4-5, and Natel O'Grady standing behind the goal in no rush. My watch is reading 32 minutes and 5 seconds. John Kelly from Tallow and Waterford wondering to know when the whistle will be blown in the centre as they come forward again. Now the cornerback, the man of the match in the second half, Earl, drives the ball up the field towards Shanahan. Shanahan inside, he's racing forward for the goalkeeper, O'Leary. Houlihan, forget about it, it's all over. Sexton Street are the champions since 1967. They haven't won it, but it's got to the back of the net. Houlihan, the man that put it in there from a dare. A goalie, his third year playing Harty Cup. It's all over. Now the crowd has gone absolutely wild. The crowd here at this side of the field. The game is not really over yet, but there's been turmoil at this, the right-hand side of the field, and Sexton Street are certainly the champions of Munster College's hurling after a lapse of 26 years. The crowd has
Nina has never seen anything like it before. Willie Moore at Pat Flory and Joe McGrath in the far side of the field. Willie has the sleeves pulled up, but I can tell you he's entitled it. They've worked for more years than one would care to remember to bring back the Harty Cup to Limerick. They come forward again. Flannan's never say die attitude. They're still battling, trying to bring it up. It's all over, I think. That's it. End of story. Limerick CBS as a champion. Oh, what a game. They looked at times that they were out of it, but they did it, and they did it in style today. 1-12 to 5-5, a really tremendous and a marvellous game. 33 minutes and 41 seconds of play in the second half. Just look at the crowd. They've come from all over Limerick today to be with these players who have done so well. Remember when Sexton Street do well at colleges hurling, so too do Limerick at large. Well, the boys has nearly got it me at this stage. It is truly one hell of a marvellous game here at McDonough Park in Nina. Just look at David Holmes with number 6 on his back there, trying to get through. They're all heroes. There's not just one today, but I would have to single out Pat Earls in the second half. But what about Willie Moore, Pat Flory and Joe McGrath, who have worked tirelessly? They're all put up on shoulders, and they're entitled to be put on the shoulders today after a tremendous victory in this Dr. Harty Cup competition that was first inaugurated in 1918. CBS have a proud tradition in it. The tradition comes forward here in McDonough Park today, and the crowd, they're really enjoying it. Let's go over and have a look at the presentation and meet some of the people that have made this game possible.
Putting in the effort all year long. I'd like to thank the school, our supporters. Well, yeah! Most of all, I'd like to thank 3 men in charge of us the last number of years. Willie Moore, Pat Flory, and Joe McGrath. I'd like to thank Flannan for a great game. And three cheers for Flannan. Hip hip! Hip hip!
Well, it's been described more of relief than excitement here at McDonough Park in Nina. And really, this cup is what the Dr. Harty Cup is all about. David Holmes, your captain of the team, what's it like to eventually get that coveted cup that you've worked so hard for?
It's great, like it's third year at it now. And it's all came to school really far to win a Harty. Heard so much about it, like, so delighted now, it's great.
Has it really sunk in yet? Because there's only one way to win a Dr. Harty Cup competition, that's to beat the likes of North Mon, St. Coleman, and then beat St. Flannan.
I think tonight now I'll realise, so we really have it won, you know. It's just the crowd and all that at the moment hasn't sunk in yet.
Was there any stage during the game that you thought that you had left it after you?
No, they were 1 point up at half time. We were always a little bit ahead there, start of the second half. And once we got on top, once we got the rhythm going at all, you know, it's great character in the team and we don't like to lose. That's it.
One of the things about the game that came to the fore was a great fighting spirit, great heart.
Yeah, there's great commitment in the team and we've worked really hard for it, you know. So, just delighted now.
How will you, academic-wise, you won't be worried, I'd say, for the next couple of weeks?
I still have to do it, you know. Still have to get it to the right.
David Hennessy, you've got a unique collection of medals going back to your household today. It's really a great afternoon for you and your family.
It's a great afternoon. It really hasn't sunk in yet, but it's a great day for me, my father, and my grandfather, who's not alive, but surely going to cherish this moment.
Your grandfather had won a Dr. Harty Cup medal, your father and yourself. A great collection of medals, and I think one that you'll really look upon in the years to come.
It is, yeah. They're above the wall now at home, and there's a space there, and I'll shove that Harty Cup medal in between it as soon as I go home.
Well, they've been described as the three musketeers that actually came to the Limerick CBS all together in 1977. Willie, starting with you, it's possibly one of the greatest sporting moments of your time at CBS.
There's no doubt about it. It's the greatest night in CBS. There's no doubt about that. We waited a long time for it. And as you said earlier on, it's a relief more than ecstasy having won it. It's a long time coming.
Joe, I saw you pacing around the pitch during the game at an unmerciful pace, trying to keep them going. Was there ever a stage that you thought that it had slipped away from you?
During the middle of the second half, they came really strong. Awful has got to be tired. We're physically working a stronger team probably, and physically they got on top of us, and they didn't look great with about 10, 12 minutes to go. So all of us kept plugging away at it, and we got the breaks at the right time before they got a chance to recover again at the end. We had won the match.
Pat, you told me before the game started that it was all about just getting it between the ears and doing it on the day, and I think that's exactly what happened in your case.
Yeah, well, a lot of people have said about this team that they have stuck into the opposition all along. They've never let any opposition away on them, you know. They've always been in there, hanging in there and hoping for a few breaks. And all year we've been lucky enough, we've been getting them, you know. Other years we've had teams that you might say could have looked better on paper or whatever, but at the end of the day, we got the breaks this year. And I mean, we're a long ways back from September when we lost the challenge game by 22 points. And
when you look at that too, Willie, down through the years there has been some great teams, most notably in 84 that failed to win that coveted trophy. But there was a better mix in this team, hurlers and workers.
They're definitely workers, but the 84 team were very close to it. It was a draw the first day and they were beaten the second day. They were very close to winning it the first day. This team are team workers, there's no doubt about that. At the start of the year, to be honest, we didn't think they were going to win the Harty Cup, but they stuck to the task, and I think they improved in every match. They had problems today at scoring points. We were a bit short of points with maybe 10 minutes to go, but it all came right. As Pat said, we've been getting the breaks all the year. That's the difference between winning and losing that.
But, Joe, when the ball started to go into the forward line, St. Flannan seemed to be a little bit shaky. Their backs were a little bit shaky.
Their full back line and goalie lost their composure, I'd say, right throughout the second half. And there was always a danger that we were going to get a goal. But as Willie says, they kept plugging away, and if you keep plugging away and want to get into the right spot, the breaks will probably arrive for you. I said, this team back along the years, they worked hard. A lot of them got into a right cup final and got beaten in it. A lot of them got into a couple of Dean Ryan finals, got beaten in it, and hopefully this today will be a mighty consolation for that group of players.
What does it mean for the school, Pat? What does it mean for the continuation of hurling in Limerick?
Well, you can't even begin to realise what it means for the school, because we've been fighting a hard battle there for, well, you could say 26 years to win, and we've been there 16 years, and there were a lot of years when you could feel like throwing your hat at it because you could never see it coming. Willie's laughing there, and we often said it after the evenings, like, we came up here 2 years ago to play Flannan's, and we thought we had a good team, and it was a good team, and they beat us out the gate. So hopefully it'll turn the corner for Sexton Street, and a lot of fellas who have ambitions to play Harty Cup will know where to come from now on.
Finally, Willie, when Limerick CBS are doing well, it augurs well for hurling in Limerick City and indeed the county in general.
That's right. It has in the past anyway. In the 60s, a lot of the players who won Harty Cup in the 60s went on to play with the county team afterwards very successfully, and hopefully this will spark them off to something similar.
What an outstanding game of hurling, 112-5-5, and the verdict going to St. Michael's CBS of Limerick in a tremendous Harty Cup hurling final. A game that really will bring back the spirit of hurling in that particular school. Barry Foley, the half-back from Patrick's Well, well, he was judged the man of the match after the game in a truly outstanding contest.
Products, conceived in Ballinasloe, developed in Raheem, and supplying the world.
Back in the early 1800s, Thomas Carling embarked on an historic journey. It took him from his homeland to the snow-capped peaks of Canada. There, amidst the ice and the snow and the pure air, he discovered a very special brewing technique known as cold filtering. It made his lager as cool as the landscape that inspired him. Carling Black Label Lager, cold filtered.
Gleason Sports Scene, 25 Upper William Street, Limerick. Ireland's most extensive sports emporium. A golfer's paradise. A footballer's dream. A keep fit oasis. The Racket Sports Center Court. Gleason Sports Scene, 25 Upper William Street, Limerick, for all your sporting needs.
Things happen.